people are going to die because of this legislation. Like, it's not even a question.
Maybe it's the sex trade that's inherently dangerous.
I really just wish people would listen to sex workers. Instead of like going out there and detaining us, why don't you talk to us?
I'm here in New York to find out what it's like to be a sex worker right now in America.
In Australia, many of our states and territories have either legalized or decriminalized sex work. But here in the US, prostitution is legal in just one of 50 states.
Liara Rue has been a sex worker, advocate, and adult film star for 5 years.
What's a regular week or month like for you, and how much would you actually make?
My best month, I made $80,000, I think.
Procuring sex work online has given her a pretty good lifestyle. But across the US, many sex workers don't have the means that she does, working on the streets in a profession that's highly criminalized.
In smaller cities or towns in the middle of the country where the police force is more conservative, it can be really dangerous. And often the police are the ones who are perpetrators of violence against sex workers, or police may use threats of being arrested to rape women.
Liara says that in the US, the criminalization of sex work is propped up by powerful conservative lobby groups and organizations.
A lot of these organizations believe that sex work is inherently dehumanizing to women, and they hate that some people actually enjoy it. They want to say that we don't exist, but I love my work.
For them, it's like a holy war. If they can destroy the sex industry, then they can destroy women being sexual objects.
My name is Maya Morena. I'm 24 years old. I am a sex worker and a dreamer.
Maya comes from a conservative family with high expectations. She did well academically, doing honors and taking college-level classes while still in high school.
The way I got into sex work was very gradual. I had this Tumblr and I used to take like pin-up kind of selfies, and then I started taking all my clothes off and I still called it art, and then I slipped a finger inside and I just couldn't call it art anymore, it was porn. I could make $3,000 to $5,000 a month. I was choosing to be my own boss and making my own choices.
For Maya, doing sex work wasn't just a rebellion against a conservative family. It was also a rebellion against a country that didn't want to accept her. When she was 6 years old, Maya was smuggled into the US from Honduras in Central America.
My grandmother was murdered in the farm that we were living in. A bunch of people broke into the house. They had two bullets to her head and one in her back. We don't really trust the police there, so we ended up sleeping with her right next to us. And then when we woke up, we told the villagers that she had passed away and we had a funeral.
For most of her life, Maya has been living in the US as an undocumented immigrant, meaning she had no legal immigration status. In the US, they call these kids dreamers.
I always dreamed of being a culture anthropologist. I watched all my friends going to work at 14 and driving at 16, voting at 18. It was really heartbreaking.
In 2012, she was granted protection under Obama's Deferred Action for Childhood Arrivals legislation, or DACA.
After all, most of these immigrants have been here a long time. They work hard, often in tough, low-paying jobs.
That gave her a 2-year right to live, work, and study in the US with no guarantee of citizenship.
The average undocumented immigrants, it takes them like 10 years in order to go to get a bachelor's. I admire immigrants that have that much hope and that much drive, because for me, it's like this card only gives me the right to be here for 2 years. Now in this administration, like that's something they're really fighting to take away even, so.
Build that wall! Build that wall!
The program known as DACA that was effectuated under the Obama administration is being rescinded.
In 2017, Trump announced he was ending DACA, with Maya and 800,000 other dreamers facing an uncertain future. That was challenged in the federal court, and today, the future of DACA remains unclear.
Growing up, I tried to be as perfect as I could be, because I had this idea that if I was just good enough that people would give me more opportunities, but the opposite has happened. I tried to join the Navy, and the next month, that option was cut for me. I tried to get good grades, and that wasn't enough. I tried to be a good model citizen. All these policies make me feel really devalued, and they slowly crush my voice.
Maya's story is not uncommon. Many undocumented immigrants end up in jobs that are unregulated and hidden from the public view. This also makes them prime targets for trafficking, with women and kids forced into the trade against their will. Right now, a new law is hoping to stem the tide of sex trafficking, but may make consensual sex work much more dangerous. In April 2018, a bill was passed into law in the US known as Foster Sesta. The aim was to curb sex trafficking on online personal sites like Backpage, a popular site for posting ads, especially for sex work, but also for sex trafficking. Legally, Backpage and other websites could not be held responsible for sex trafficking content posted by their users. Now, due to Foster Sesta, they can. It allows greater policing of these sites and opens them up to lawsuits from trafficking survivors. But the language of the law is pretty vague, penalising all websites that promote or facilitate prostitution, meaning a whole bunch of sex-related content and websites are disappearing, and sex workers around the world using US-based sites are being cut off.
Sex work is an entirely different issue than human trafficking.
I've heard reports of people being homeless. I've heard reports of people going missing. For a lot of people who used to be able to work online and were able to screen clients that way, they've been pushed onto the streets. So it means that it's harder for them to make sure that the client that they're seeing is legitimate. They have to totally go off their gut, which makes it really hard. It's really dangerous. People are really scared. A lot of people are going to die because of this legislation. Like, it's not even a question.
It's clear that this law is making sex work a lot more dangerous. But are sex workers just unintended casualties in a war against sex trafficking? Or were they always in the firing line?
FOSTA targets websites. It doesn't target adult services sections, it doesn't target individuals, and we don't want individuals who are consensually selling sex to be targeted.
Romina Canessa runs the Anti-Sex Trafficking Program at Equality Now, a women's rights organization that helped draft and pass Foster Sesta.
Foster Sesta was needed because there was this explosion of the online marketplace for commercial sex. And many of those affected were children and trafficked women. I think throughout their lifetime, Backpage made almost $500 million. And just making money off of selling children for sex, for rape.
So Foster Sesta is, by a lot of anecdotal reports, forcing people to conduct work on the streets rather than online, where they can't vet their clients, possibly putting them at danger.
I mean, I'd just first like to make clear, Equality Now doesn't want anyone to be in danger, and there's also women being killed on Backpage before. It just goes to show that maybe it's the sex trade that's inherently dangerous.
Romina says the law is already working.
The online marketplace has been reduced already, 30 to 40% of what it was before FOSTA. So that, for us, is a huge impact.
I did feel safe in the industry because of the network that I had for myself. Like, we had support networks online. All our support networks are gone, so I can't do it anymore. It's just too unsafe.
Maya has moved home to her parents. She doesn't want to work on the streets, where she's a target for rogue police, pimps, and johns.
It just puts the power in the wrong hands when you have a criminalized system.
With the midterm elections around the corner, for Maya, her only hope is that the next few years will bring change, both for immigrants and sex workers.
And sometimes I get scared because if, like, something happens, people can't really hear me as brightly. As somebody who has just an open world that listens to them, I hope that the people who can vote would open up that world for me, because it hurts to not be able to vote, and it hurts to watch other people vote for your life.
It sounds like you have been let down.
Yeah. Everyone promised me that they were gonna help me. And things turned out the way that my cynical mind thought that they would. And that's really disappointing. That I'm used to being disappointed. I'm not a dreamer anymore. I'm just kind of dreaming for another day.